Hi, John Hess here from FilmmakerIQ.com. This IQ Bits video is an addendum to our Science of Exposure and Metering video, because we kind of need to talk. I mean, what the
Facebook
is middle gray? Middle gray, middle gray, middle gray, middle gray, middle gray to as middle gray to middle gray. Well, middle gray is simply halfway between white and black. See? Here's black. Here's white, and that's halfway. That's what we call middle gray. I hope this has been helpful for your cinematic journey, so go out there and make something. Oh, you want me to go into more detail on what exactly is middle gray? Okay, I guess we can do an experiment. So I've got this exposure reference pop-up. Let's take a spot meter reading of the black and white portions. With the black, I'm getting 90 candels per square meter. With the white, I'm getting 1,400 candels per meter squared. So middle gray ought to be the average between the white reading and the black reading, say 745 candels per square meter.
Let's try spot metering the middle gray, and not even close, the middle gray is 360 candels per square meter.
That's because our perception of color and lightness don't respond in a linear fashion. Well, that's why in photography, we always talk in stops of powers of two. So that means if we want to find the halfway point between white and black, we don't take an arithmetic average, we take a geometric mean.
We multiply the figures together and take the square root, which ends up being 354.9 candels per meter squared. Really, really close to what I measured with the spot meter.
This geometric mean approach was how middle gray was determined as early as 1903. They basically took a geometric mean between a white and black that had a ratio of 60 to 1. The middle gray was an equivalent of 12.9% of the white intensity. But you've probably heard of Kodak 18% gray card. Where does 18% fall into all of this?
Well, 18% actually comes from the halftone screen printing process dating all the way back to the 1880s. Printers use these 18% gray cards to calibrate the ink flow. The 18% meant it reflected 18% of the light that hits it. If you think about printing in terms of stops, 18% is the geometric mean between white paper, which is 95% reflectance, and black ink, which is 3.5% reflectance. When Ansel Adams and Fred Archer published the zone system in 1941, they used this 18% gray card that printers use as a reference for middle gray, or zone 5.
Later in the 20th century, we get even more precise printing color spaces like lab color space.
In lab, color is described in terms of L for luminance and A and B for color opposites red-green and yellow-blue. Middle gray is literally 50% L value, which, once you do the math, comes to precisely 18.42% CIE-XYZ luminance.
However, that is from the print side. We're dealing with capturing light. When Adams clarified how to use the 18% gray card, he recommended the card be held so that it was tilted halfway in the direction of the light, effectively darkening the card. Kodak's instructions when they manufactured and sold gray cards recommended that readings using these cards ought to be raised a half a stop, which effectively put middle gray at 12% reflectance.
And 12.8% is what the ANSI PH3.49-1971 sets as a standard for what middle gray is when it comes to light meters.
Now, 18% or 12%, I really doubt most of you watching would find that big a difference between the two. The nice thing about digital is we have a whole host of tools to help further make our decisions. Tools like histograms and waveforms. Using a gray card is almost like using an incidence meter with a waveform.
Put the card in the shot and get the gray card to hit the middle of the waveform. Now keep in mind that 90 IRE is pretty much white, and 7.5 IRE is pretty much the bottom of black. So your middle gray card should sit between 38 and 55 IRE. Well, that's a big range.
But it comes down to your camera, your recording format, and your own personal taste. In the end, middle gray is a pretty elusive thing.
I mean, look at this image and tell me which tile is darker. A or B. The truth is, perception is a powerful, powerful thing.
Well, there you have it. Expect to see a bunch of photo nerds arguing over this until the internet ceases to exist. Of course, that would be nothing new. I'm John Hess. Give this video a like, subscribe, hit the bell, and consider popping over to Patreon and becoming a patron. Until next time, I will see you at filmmakeriq.com.